How long is it since you last ate, Lynn? Lynn.
About a week.
Is this true?
Yes.
You're going to have to start eating again.
No.
Now be sensible. You're on the verge of malnutrition.
I don't care.
Well, then you should care about the baby.
What baby?
Didn't know you were pregnant.
I can't be. There's no one. No one. Only that man.
What man?
I told you. He wouldn't believe me. The man who raped me. It's his baby.
You're 3 months pregnant, Lynn. It's too late for an abortion now, even if I agreed.
No, I don't want a baby. I don't want. Please help me. Oh, God.
Meg.
I'll kill myself. You've got to get rid of it.
Shh.
Oh, I don't want to have a baby. Please help me get rid of it.
Come on, shh. I don't want it.
It's just a mild sedative. It'll help you sleep.
Oh, please, I don't want that animal's baby. Please get rid of it.
Meg. Why wasn't I told this girl hasn't been eating?
She was looking for attention.
That's not the point. It is your duty as officer in charge to report this sort of thing, or had you forgotten? If I can't get this girl eating soon, then I'm going to have to force feed her. Do you realize what that involves?
Well, shouldn't you be telling her that?
By rights, I should report you to the governor.
Well, that's your prerogative. Now, if you'll excuse me...
Meg! She's not much older than your son.
Who is now without a father, if you remember.
Yes. I also remember an officer who used to have a little bit of human decency.
Will you turn that bloody thing off?
Is Lynn okay?
She just fainted.
Oh, I reckon I'd die if I start.
Sure would, Lizzie.
Rightio, who's next?
Oh, come on, that's us. Do you want anything at the buyer?
No, thanks.
Don't forget the fags, Lizzie.
Get lost, Frankie.
Says who?
What's the matter? Didn't you get enough last time?
How's your little friend going? Getting sweet on her, huh? Or maybe you're just like sucking up to the screw.
Why don't you?
Why don't I what, sweetie?
Maybe Lynn would have been all right if you'd all just treated her like a human being.
She doesn't deserve it. But you, I'll treat you any way you like. Just give me the word.
You make me sick.
I'll come across.
I told you to get lost, Frankie.
And you can get off your soapbox too. Look, you gotta be tough to live in a place like this. And it's up to Lynn if she wants to make a go of it.
You're talking about surviving, aren't you? Not living. What would any of you know about living?
Do you reckon you're any different?
Jeanette Mary Brooks, you have pleaded guilty to the charge of shoplifting. Before passing sentence, however, I feel it is my duty to explain the reason why I see fit to impose a severe sentence. Apart from breaking your parole, you've offered the court no explanation for having done so, nor it would seem was there any motive for your breaking the law. According to the arresting officer's statement, and that of your parole officer, you'd been taken in by your daughter and her family and given a good home. You left their care of your own free will and resorted back to a life of crime without any thought of the hurt and suffering you would cause them. You were given every opportunity to lead a normal, respectable life. Therefore, it is the duty of this court to sentence you to a term of 3 years' imprisonment. It sees no reason why a parole period be specified during the term of your sentence.
Thank you very much, sir.
Next. next case before the court is the Crown versus Martin Walton.
Lizzie, will you stop pushing or I'll send you to the end of the line?
Oh. Cheryl Brown.
Who'd waste their money on stuff like that?
No talking, Lizzie. Well, come on, you're holding everyone up.
Birdsworth, Elizabeth Josephine.
Cute.
Your friend Doyle hasn't shown up again. Frankie's such a heavy smoker. I wonder how she manages.
Maybe she's knocked off.
You stupid Birdsworth.
Yes, Miss Bennett.
Well, I'm glad I'm not in with Frankie anymore. Bee doesn't expect payoffs.
Yeah, well, I'm not going to give her anything else.
She'll kill you.
Not if I tell her old Bennett stopped me buy-ups because we gave the lip.
Good luck. You're going to need it.
Holding out on me, Lizzie?
No, Frankie. It's just that there are too many sneak thieves around.
Oh, yeah, sure there are. Did you get my fags?
No. And even if I had, I wouldn't give you any. You get your own stuff.
Now, is that any way to talk, Lizzie? Who'll look after you if I don't?
I don't need anyone to look after me. Anyway, what are you saving up for, your old age?
You should be worried about your old age, Lizzie. Old bones take a long time to heal.
What are you doing in here, Doyle?
Bill just went, finished work.
Must have flown to get here so fast.
That's me, Swifty. See you later, Lizzie.
Anything wrong, Lizzie?
No, Mrs. Jackson.
G'day.
Hey, I've got something to tell you.
Well, that's good news, I hope.
Well, you could call it that.
All right. Well, g'day. Listen, it's getting a bit crowded in here. Why don't we go over to the parlour?
Okay. Oh.
Hey.
Watch you, Marilyn. You know what they say about electricians?
What do they say?
Always blowing a girl's fuse.
Oh. What are you doing?
Oh, I'm knitting booties for Rosie's baby. And then I'm going to knit a jumper for Teddy.
Do you know how to knit?
Oh, it can't be that hard.
Oh,
can't be.
Oh, geez, turn into a real little lady, aren't you? Good day, darling.
You're beautiful, you know that? So what's your news? What's that?
It's the pill, silly. I had to bribe an officer to get it. At least we'll be safe for the next month.
Well, are you sure that'll be all right? I mean...
Oh, Eddie, I've been taking it for years when I was on the game. Well, Eddie, you know that's why I'm in here. It was just a job. You're not Eddie.
Anyone seen Marilyn Mason? Well? Where's that electrician?
Electrician? Oh, I haven't seen any electrician. Anyone else seen one?
Here. Why don't you
pictures out of someone else's magazine for a change.
What do you mean you're
your exactly what I want? Right up here, too.
Quick, Vera. Stay there.
Get out of my way. Get out of my way. What's going on?
Where have you been?
To the loo.
You two, no television for 2 nights. The governor wants to see you. You didn't have to clonk me so hard, did you?
You got a few buttes in yourself.
Well, 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 look who's here. All right.
Thank you, Miss Bennett. You've been with us now for 6 months, haven't you, Marilyn?
Yes, Mrs. Davidson.
And not your first offence, either.
No, I did a short stretch last year.
For the same offence.
Well, it's not fair, Mrs. Davidson. The girls always get the book thrown at them. Well, never the customer.
Yes, well, I didn't call you in here to discuss the law. As you know, your parole is almost due. You are to be released in 2 days.
Well, that's just... Well, hell, that's fantastic!
I hope I won't see you back here again.
Oh, no way. I swore to my mother I'd do no more porn movies.
And your other line of work?
Modelling.
Prostitution.
Oh, I'm not going down for that again.
All right, Marilyn, you can go.
I had your teacher on the phone, young lady, and I had to tell her I didn't know where my own daughter was. She must have thought I was a complete and utter fool. Now, I demand to know where you've been.
I was in court.
In court? I wanted to see my grandmother. She needed somebody there with her. You don't care what happens to her?
Not anymore, no.
She's your mother. And I've visited her for 14 years. 14 until I couldn't take it anymore. Oh, she's no good, darling.
Why? What's she ever done to you?
Well, I don't want to discuss it.
Look, Mum, I've got a right to know.
You'll do as you're told and stay away from her. She's out of our lives for good, understand?
No. I'm going to see her again.
All right. She killed your grandfather, is that what you wanted to hear? She murdered him and I'll never forgive her for that.
Don't keep her talking too long. Lynn, it's Meg Jackson. Do you want to talk about the baby? Would it do any good to contact the father? Do you want to tell me about it? Perhaps I can help.
I told the truth at the trial. Nobody wanted to help then.
You could try me. How long were you with the Bentleys?
Just the 2 days.
Were you enjoying it?
She was a bit strange. He seemed nice. I loved little Richie.
Yes?
The night before I left, Mrs. Bentley had gone away. Mr. Bentley had just received
just
a call from his airline.
Uh-huh. Well, that can't be helped. 24 hours at least. Right.
What's the trouble?
Flight's been cancelled. Industrial dispute.
Mrs. Bentley wouldn't have gone to her mother's if she'd known.
Ah, she's been planning that trip for months. She's lucky to have you to look after Richie.
Well, I'm just about to put on some dinner. Will you be staying in?
Why not? Give us a chance to get to know each other a bit better. You're quite a find, you know that? A beautiful girl. An excellent nursemaid. And now I discover you're a marvellous cook.
Well, my mother's a fantastic cook, and she just believes every girl should learn for when they get married.
Ah, an old-fashioned mother. I didn't know we still had them.
I think that's all they breed in the country.
And what about marriage, Lynn? Is there a young man in your life?
Not really.
I don't believe that. I bet you've had dozens.
Well, I didn't think anything of it. I thought he was just being friendly. I remember he'd been drinking. He just put on a record.
Drink?
thank you, Mr. Bentley.
Look! Let's forget the Mr. Business. Paul, eh?
Let me go.
Not until we've had a dance together. Oh, come on, Lynn, relax. We're going to have a lovely evening together.
Please, Mr. Bentley, you've been drinking.
Maybe that's what you need.
Mr. Bentley!
Come on, baby, listen up, eh? Why not? Now, you're just being a silly little girl. Open the door.
Took the baby because Mr. Bentley raped you.
I didn't take Richie. I didn't. Oh, why would anyone believe me?
Well, I'll be blowed. Letting anybody out in the streets these days.
You'd know. They let you out.
Mm. Half your luck, but you deserve it.
She'll be back. Whores can never stay off their back for too long.
Put a sock in it, Doyle.
Come on, Eddie. Don't take any notice.
Wish I was getting out in 2 days.
No, oh, you'll be out before you know it.
My little girl turned 4 last week.
Yeah?
First birthday I've missed.
Oh, there'll be lots of others. You'll see.
She thinks I'm in hospital.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Hey, how about some telly? Turn it on, will you?
Yeah. Oh, what a shame. But then I thought you said you hadn't got any cigarettes. Up at the next
bend. Well, at least we won't have to sneak around anymore.
You mean you'll still want to see me?
Well, that's a stupid thing to say. Of course I will.
But it'll be different on the outside, Eddie.
Yeah, thank God.
I've got a record.
So what? Well, listen, Marilyn, I've been doing a lot of thinking about you and me. And, like, I didn't want to say anything until I knew you were getting out, but... Well, I don't know how you feel about me, but... Well, I love you and I want to marry you.
Eddie!
I know I'm not much chop and everything, but... Well, what do you say? If you need more time, well, that's okay. But I reckon you and me could make a real good go of it.
Oh, Eddie, I can't. I'm sorry.
Hey, what the hell's he done to you? What have you been saying to her?
Wants me to marry him.
Well, fan bloody tastic. I didn't think you had it in you, kid.
She turned me down, B.
You what?
I can't.
Oh, come on, love your life, Meryl. Oh,
she'll come round.
Yeah, she's probably got someone on the outside anyway.
Well, she has. It's the best kept secret around.
Probably thinks I'm not good enough for her, something.
Oh. Hey, what's wrong with Marilyn?
She just heard she's being released.
Oh, terrific. I wonder if they'll put Mum in with us.
Mum?
Yeah, she's back. She's sitting outside the governor's office now.
I can't see why we shouldn't give Mum back her old room. Who's in there now?
Ferguson.
Well, move her into Doyle's dormitory. I think she should be safe from Frankie, don't you? Good.
I'd like to speak to you about Lynn Warner.
Of course.
You know she's pregnant. Well, she claims she was raped.
It was brought up at her trial.
And they thought she was lying?
No, she was raped all right. Apparently by some of her bikey friends.
Well, she claims it was Mr. Bentley.
There was nothing to support her story. At the time she says she was raped, Mr. Bentley was staying at a friend's.
Why would she say it was him?
Well, the sentence could have been lighter. She could have pleaded she was unbalanced at the time of the abduction. I don't know.
She just sounded so convincing.
Not to the jury, she didn't.
Well, I just thought there might be something in it. Of all the women to be brought back in here, I thought you were different. But it seems I've been wrong about a lot of things lately.
I was so sorry to hear about your husband, Mrs. Jackson. I tried to phone you when I heard.
Yes, I know. You'll be moved in with Frankie Doyle. Collect your things after tea, please.
Sorry to kick you out, love. It's good to be home.
I just don't understand you people. You've had everything waiting for you at your daughter's, and you want to come back to this.
One thing I've learned being in here, Mrs. Jackson, it isn't always the cons who end up bitter.
I'm not interested in your opinions. Why did you want to come back?
I suppose after 15 years I belong.
Rubbish! What about your family?
All those years, the one thing I really ever thought about was being with my family, but how do you get back 15 years? My grandchildren grew up without me. It's as simple as that.
Doesn't mean they don't need you.
I need them more. My granddaughter was in court. She sat there through all that. I lost her before I even got to know her.
But you could have tried.
I was a stranger. Anyway, who wants a silly old woman? They've got their own lives. I was 15 years too late.
Well, since you are back, there's something useful I want you to do for me. Remember Lynn Warner?
The one who took over the garden?
Yes. Well, I want you to find out more about her.
I don't lag on the girls, you know that.
I'm not asking you to. You know she claimed she was innocent. Well, I just want your opinion on whether she's telling the truth or not.
The longer you've been here, the harder it is to tell.
Mum, I need your help.
Oh, you're not going to throw that away, are you? You spent ages making it.
Well, I hate it now.
Oh, Bea, isn't this the most gorgeous thing you've ever seen?
Belt up, will you? I'm trying to talk to a mule about a wedding. Look, have you got rocks in your head?
I don't want to talk about it, Bea.
Yeah, well, what are you going to do when you get out, huh?
Oh, get a job.
Oh, sure you will. Doing what? What other qualifications have you got apart from lying on your back?
Look, Bea, I'll get a job. It's just too soon, that's all. Okay, you may feel one way when you're inside, but when you get out, it's different. And you know it, and Eddie will too, only he won't admit it.
Oh, I think he's nice.
Shut up. Look, I know enough about men to know that boy would never hurt you.
Yeah, but I may hurt him. I've been inside before, Bea, and I know what it's like getting out. You can't get a job, you meet some of your old
cronies.
Yeah,
you want to live high on the hog.
Well, what's wrong with that?
Nothing, if you're prepared to pay for it. And you know what that means. Listen, if you don't marry Eddie, you're going to end up back in here. Just like me and Mum.
Mum, what are you doing here?
I was about to ask you the same thing. I was arrested for shoplifting. I hear you're expecting a baby.
I don't want to have it, Mum. Can you get me something to get rid of it?
Oh, I can't do that, dear. I'm sorry we didn't get to know each other better before I left, but maybe we can make up for that, huh? Mm. Now, let's see. The last time we spoke, you were saying something about being innocent. And that hasn't changed. Well, looks like we've got a bit of a problem then, doesn't it? Why wouldn't the police believe your story, Lynn?
Because everyone else kept telling lies.
Was what you told Mrs. Jackson the truth?
Yes.
You didn't tell her what you did after Mr. Bentley attacked you?
I left straight away. I was going to catch a bus straight home, but at the station I phoned Mrs. Bentley and told her what her husband had done. Well, then the police came and arrested me. They took me back to the Bentleys. They didn't even tell me why.
If you'll go with the constable, Larry.
Are you arresting me?
No, we just want you to show us the grounds. Miss Warner. Detective Senior Sergeant Thomas. You know why we've brought you back here? Why did you leave so suddenly, Miss Warner?
Because I wanted to go home.
After being here 2 days. Now, come now, Miss Warner. Wasn't it because Mrs. Bentley fired you?
No.
What happened here last night? Mrs. Bentley said she came home and found you had been entertaining a few visitors. Bikies, apparently.
No, it's not true.
Now, where's the baby?
Richie?
Where is he?
Oh, he's in his room. I left him.
Now, we
him
both
there.
Know he's not in his room, Miss Warner. Now, what have you done with him?
Nothing. He is. Mr. Bentley, you'll know where he is.
Mr. Bentley's on his way to Singapore.
He was here last night.
We have witnesses to say he was with friends.
He wasn't. He was here.
All right, Miss Warner. All right. Now, you rang Mrs. Bentley this morning from the bus station. What did you say to her?
That I was sorry I walked out on her.
Now, didn't you say you'd put the baby away somewhere to teach her a lesson for firing you? Isn't that what you said?
They found Richie in the garden. He was buried in a box. An air hose thing kept him alive. Mum, do you believe me?
Is there anyone who can back up your story?
Well, Larry knew I didn't have any bikey friends. He didn't say anything at the trial. And he's gone away now.
Time's up, Mum.
Try and get a good night's sleep. All right.
Shut up!
What?
If you don't cut out that racket, I'll knock your flaming block off! What are you gawking at? See what happens when I'm not around to look after you.
You took them. Now give them back.
You got to learn, Lizzie. No one holds out on Frankie. You're going to wind up like that idiot who wouldn't eat. Except you won't be able to eat.
Anyone seen Lizzie? Not like her to miss out on a feed.
She's going on a diet. Oh, very
funny. I see Frankie hasn't changed.
No, she's got a chip on her shoulder. She's got a bloody log.
Seems like Lizzie's changed her mind, Frankie.
Here, wrap your gums around that, Lizzie. And don't say I don't look after you.
Did you break your teeth or something?
Built up, Doreen.
Oh.
All the lousy tricks. You're a rotten, fat cow.
You call me names and you wind up...
Oh, you just put it over there. Any more trouble and I'll report you two to the governor.
You're a pig, Lizzie.
All right. You can have your smokes.
I've just doubled the rate.
Morning, Greg. Can you spare a moment?
Sure. Social call, I hope.
No, it's Mother. She had a bad night last night, and I said I'd speak to you and arrange an appointment.
Well, I'll call over this evening if you like.
Oh, she's getting worse, Greg. I don't know what to do anymore.
You could consider putting her into a nursing home.
She wouldn't go.
Have you asked her?
No. No, I couldn't do that.
You're looking a bit run down yourself, you know. You've not been working too hard, I hope.
Oh, what choice have I got? We're an officer short, and, well, Meg's got a day off. Excuse me, Doctor.
Come in, Mum.
I just wanted to check if it's all right for me to go and see Lynn.
Sure, go right ahead.
Thanks. Oh, and then there's Mother. Well, it's not that I'm complaining. Well, you know what it's like.
It's beautiful.
The garden's never looked better, thanks to you. Bit of a green thumb, huh?
Oh, my mother used to love gardening. Mum, did you really kill someone?
Yes, dear.
But why?
That's history now, and that's where it belongs, in the past.
Do you have any children?
Oh, yes. A lovely daughter. And she's got children of her own now. There's Judith Ann, she's 16, and Andrew, he's 8. And little Benjamin, just a baby.
I don't want to have children.
You'll change your mind when it comes along. You see, there's nothing more precious than your own child.
I hate it.
You know, the baby's half yours as well. If you did anything stupid, you'd kill half of yourself.
Did you love your husband?
Yes, very much.
I'll never get married.
Maybe one day.
Oh, how? In here?
What if people start believing your story?
They won't.
I do.
We're debating against King's Grammar today.
Hmm? Oh, good.
Parents are invited. It's at 4 o'clock.
Oh, I'm sorry, Matty. I wish I could come.
But it's your day off.
Yes, I know, but I've got to go out.
Something to do with the prison, isn't it?
Yes. And it's important, Marty, really. Otherwise, I'd come.
It doesn't matter.
Well, next time, all right?
Sure.
See you later. Bye, darling. Marty! Good luck.
Eddie ain't coming in.
Maybe he's got another call.
I heard him, B. I know I'll never see him again. I just know it.
Eddie's not the one to run out on him. Hey, do you think this dress does anything for me?
Oh, very sexy. Lizzie's only being my dressmaker's dummy.
Gummy's more like brainless and toothless.
Oh, don't take any notice of her.
I'm not worried.
I'm getting out of here soon.
What do you mean? Wirecutters. You coming with me? No. I've got nowhere to go.
Frankie Doyle?
Yeah.
You got a visitor.
How you going, sis?
G'day, Squirt!
Look at you. Talk about skinny gutter. Don't they feed you in that place?
Not in them anymore, Frankie. Left yesterday. I'd have come to see you then, but it's a bit late.
How'd they treat you, Gazza?
Oh, you know. Okay. For an orphanage. Worst part was not being allowed to see you. She didn't miss much. What are you doing? Got a job in the supermarket. Oh, just lifting and cleaning. But I only start till I get some bread together.
Where are you living? And who's taking care of you?
Gee, sis, I'm 16, you know. I've got a room in a house. Sharing with a couple of blokes and a girl.
Yeah, well, you just keep your nose clean. If any of them give you any trouble, you let me know, all right?
Hey, look familiar?
Geez, you'll have to grow up a bit before you fit into that, Gazza.
You don't care?
Nah, what would I do with it round here? Except scare a few screws.
Hey, remember when you got it?
The after I got me bike.
She sure was a beaut.
Hey, how about when we took it for that burn up to Lilydale and we stopped and got them hamburgers?
Now, tough nut picked a fight with me and you clobbered
it. Yeah, nobody shakes down a Doyle and gets away with it.
Nah. But you're pretty important in here, Frankie.
Oh, yeah, I reckon.
Just a girl. Probably never seen such a good-looking bloke.
What'd she look like? Well?
Come on, give.
You'll never guess. Not in a million years.
Yeah, that's how long you'll be dead if you don't tell us.
Well, it's a bloke. Frankie's got a bloke.
Nah.
You gotta be kidding.
It's true. Honest. He's pretty young, but you should have seen the way they were laughing and carrying on.
Well, I'll be blown.
Marilyn Mason, you got a visitor. Well, go on, get on with your work. And Lizzie, take that ludicrous dress off.
Yeah, well, I suppose it is a bit bright.
Want to show us something, Frankie? Hey, that's private.
She probably thinks it's an escape plan or something.
Well, what do you reckon?
Oh, yeah? What is it?
It's a place I want to build.
Why not?
In the country.
The country?
Well, you always said you liked open spaces.
So what?
So, for when you get out.
Oh, God, I'll be pushing up daisies by the time I get out of this place.
You will not. Now, look, we're all figured. And I've saved a bit in the supermarket. I'll get a job on a farm, work for a few years, get a bit of land and build that. You'll be out by the time it's finished.
You've got rocks in your head.
Says who?
Says me. Can you see me in the country? Frankie Doyle bringing in the cows.
And what's wrong with that?
And what would you know about farming anyhow?
I can learn. And it wouldn't hurt you to learn something for a change either.
And whose fault's that? I wouldn't have had to spend all those years in the factory sweating if it hadn't been for you hanging around my neck.
Mr. Frankie.
Me too, Gazza. Me too.
You've got half an hour, Gladys.
Gladys?
Well, that's my real name, but I hate it, so everyone calls me Marilyn. Oh, blabbermouth. You're looking very smart today.
Yeah, this is what I'm going to wear to our wedding.
Oh, Eddie, I'm sorry I didn't explain before, but I've had time to think about it, and I don't want to rush into anything. Well, not yet, anyway. I'll need time. So will you. If you're having trouble hearing, Miss Bennett, I'll talk louder. If you want, I'll move in with you as a sort of trial run. And if it works out, well, then I'd love to marry you.
Yeah, but I still don't see what...
Please, Eddie, trust me. I have my reasons.
Whatever you want, Marilyn.
Cheers, hot in here.
Sit down again. Say, Karen, you won't have to worry about Frankie anymore. I hear a rumour she's going straight.
Huh.
In more ways than one.
Hey, Doreen.
Yeah?
Come outside for a sec. Got something to show you.
Oh!
What'd you do that?
Oh. I've changed my mind. I'm coming with you.
Oh, that's a good laugh.
Can I help you?
Oh, Mr. Bentley?
Oh, hardly. I'm the gardener.
Not Larry, by any chance?
Yes. How did you know?
Well, I am...
I know. You're a friend of Mrs. Bentley, right?
Is she home?
No, I'm afraid she won't be home all the afternoon.
New nursemaid doesn't seem to be doing a very good job.
She won't have one near the place, not after that last girl.
You mean the baby's by itself?
So what's new? Well, she treats that kid short of her head red.
Larry,
I'm a friend of Lynn Warner's. I was wondering if I could ask you a few questions.
Excuse me, I've got work to do.
Now, I want you to start eating again, young lady. I saw Larry today. He's still working for the Bentleys, and he wouldn't talk to me exactly. But I think there's a good enough reason for your case to be reopened. Now, I can't promise anything, and I don't want you to raise your hopes too high. But I can promise I will speak to the governor. All right?
Senior Sergeant Holborn, please. Hello, Jack. Erica Davidson here. Fine, thanks. Jack, do you remember the Lynn Warner case? That's the one. Well, I was hoping next time you're out this way, you might drop in for a chat. Good. Well, one of my officers feels there are some doubts about the girl's guilt. And so do I.
That's good to see. Now, remember, you've got to keep your strength up.
Excuse me, Doctor. The medicinal alcohol is missing again.
Again? Was it locked?
Yes.
God, some of these women are better than Houdini. You better get me a list of everyone we've seen during the last 2 days.
What are you up to?
Me and Lizzie are getting out.
Someone to see you, Mum.
To see me?
Hello, Grandma.
My dear girl. Does your mother know you're here?
No, I'm old enough to make up my own mind. Oh, this is a dreadful place. How can you stand it here?
I've got a lot of friends here.
When I was little, I used to envy all the other kids because they had grandparents. And that meant being spoiled with stories and presents and visits.
I wish your grandfather and I could have shared those moments. We missed them too.
What was he like?
Oh, he was about the finest man I've ever known. He was kind, gentle, never said a harsh word to anyone, and smart. He would have been proud of you, Judy.
What did he die of?
He was very ill, in great pain. I've got a picture of him, if you'd like it.
Why did you kill him? Mum told me.
We had 20 good years together. Most people are lucky to have one. When Jim found out he was going to die, he said he didn't mind, so long as it was quick. Not that he was a coward. But he didn't want me to watch him die, you see. But I did. I watched him suffer and waste away for 6 months. He was such a good man. He shouldn't have suffered. And he never complained. But some nights I'd wake up and he'd be crying with the pain. He'd tell me it was because he didn't want to leave me, but I knew that was only part of it. When he couldn't stand it any longer, he asked me to help him. I couldn't at first. I loved him too much. But I did. And I held him.
Could I come and see you again, Grandma?
Lizzie? Lizzie? It's time to go. Wake up. Lizzie? But it's time to go. Everything's organized. Wake up.
Go away. Gotta sleep. Gotta sleep.